So I always start with social impairment because I see this as the heart and soul of autism. If you don't have social impairment, you don't have autism. But first, let me share some case examples from my clinic to demonstrate what this can look like and the huge range in severity that we see in the children we treat. So on one end of the spectrum, you have kids who even at a pretty young age have kind of some awareness that their social skills aren't great. And they're lonely, and they really want to make friends, but they're just not great at it. So recently I asked a 10-year-old kid, what does having autism mean to you? And he said, well, it means that sometimes I don't know that I'm being annoying, which makes other kids not want to play with me. Poor kid. And the thing about social impairment in autism is it starts young and it lasts throughout the lifetime. So recently I had another conversation, this time with the mother of a young adult man with autism, and I said, how have the social challenges changed over time? And she said, you know, Dr. Thom, when he was first diagnosed, we worked so hard, we did all the social skills groups, we did everything, and I thought things would get better. But they really haven't. In fact, as the social environment got more and more complex as he got older and older, think about dating and all the things that come with middle school and beyond, things have gotten much more tricky, such that now he really prefers to hang out with us, his parents. And this was causing a lot of family friction, because this was a 19-year-old young man who wanted to surf, to play basketball, play video games. His parents weren't really into those things. Then I just had to share this last anecdote, because it breaks my heart. We do see people with very severe autism who have, as far as we know, very, very little interest or desire in social connection. So this was a mother of an adult man, probably in his 30s or 40s, who said, you know, I have to believe deep down that he knows I love him, but he's so much in his own world that sometimes I do wonder if he wouldn't notice if I died. So that's social impairment in autism. Now here's the long and the short of it, and it's kind of easy because there's only one thing to remember, and that there are no meds that treat this.